everyone. Tom Parks from Annex Wealth Management, Director of Retirement Plans, joined today by Joey Backus. Can you give us a little background on yourself, please?
Yeah, absolutely. Thanks for having me, Tom. My name is Joey Backus. I'm an employee benefits consultant at Cottingham and Butler. Cottingham and Butler is the 23rd largest brokerage firm in the country, and we really focus on helping small to middle market businesses with their employee benefits plan financially, operationally, and creating employee engagement.
Fantastic. All right. And the reason I invited you here today is because we are in the thick of open enrollment season.
Yes, we are.
And unlike 401k plans, where things just kind of happen, you know, automatically, in the healthcare space, it requires a little bit more work. So I wanted to get a sense from you of, you know, what are the main things people should keep in mind? How do people get enrolled? And are there any special considerations this year that people might want to take into effect?
Sure.
Or into account?
Yeah, absolutely, Tom. And we are in the midst of open enrollment season, and it's a season that human resource professionals don't always love because they spend a lot of time with administration, and in the end, some employees don't spend a lot of attention in making their decisions. There's a bunch of different ways to do open enrollment. I'm going to narrow it down to three. There's the old-fashioned way, which is kind of like riding a bike to work, and that's paper enrollment. Basically, the way that works is every employee gets a paper form. They then take that paper form, submit it to HR or whoever is the administrator, and they input that into every single carrier portal, as well as the deductions into payroll.
That sounds like a lot of fun.
I wouldn't describe it as fun, Tom, but it is a lot of work and can leave for some inaccuracies as well.
Okay, so paper, doable, not preferable.
Yeah, think of it like a bicycle. If you're trying to get to work and you have a 10-mile drive, you can get there with a bike, but you might end up all sweaty.
You might get more points on your health system.
With your wellness plan, you might get more points.
Okay, so paper, what's the next one?
The next one, which has been really common this year, it's kind of a short-term fix with COVID, has been text to enroll. So a lot of employers are worried about the safety concerns, as well as they have a lot of people, say, working remotely or not in large groups. So text to enroll is basically using a smartphone. Okay. Cottingham Butler, we actually have a program to do this where they can make all their elections and have a kind of an Amazon-like shopping experience for their benefits on the phone. Now, instead of paper where the administrator has to put it in all the portals and put it in the payroll, we can create a moldable spreadsheet that does a batch upload.
Okay.
So much quicker process for human resources.
So the person who's doing the texting is doing a lot of the input.
They're doing
themselves.
All the actions themselves, as well as they get a shopping experience and they know what everything's going to cost for them and their family.
Yep. All right. So then why wouldn't everyone just do the text all the time?
Well, it's fairly new technology.
Okay.
As you probably see in your space, sometimes businesses do the same thing they've always done or they don't know what they don't know.
I would love that.
The last thing is maybe cost. This text to enroll or a benefit administration system, they do have costs associated with them, but we've been really successful in working with carriers to actually get them to pay for the cost of those systems, because if you think about the paper way, there's a lot of room for error, and the last thing a carrier wants to do is end up in a lawsuit because there was misaccurate information.
No, same thing. That's what we push people really hard in the 401k space. There's very little paper enrollment left. We still have clients who do it, but we encourage them to do electronic because you're transferring the information from a piece of paper on, and then if there's a fat finger error or whatever, it's your fault, and then there's an argument and all that stuff. So, okay, so paper, text, to enroll. You said benefit administration. Is that the third?
Yeah, that's
so what's the difference between that and text?
That's the third one. The text to enroll is kind of just an open enrollment solution. It doesn't manage ongoing terms and new hires. An open enrollment platform would do all of that. It would help you manage it throughout the year. And so a lot of times we take companies that are doing paper, we take a baby step, we get them away from the bike, maybe get them a Toyota Camry, they do the text to enroll, and then in the long term we push them towards a benefit administration system.
Okay.
And there's a whole slew of different kinds of benefit administration systems, so making sure that you pick the right one that fits for your company and in the landscape there.
Fantastic. All right. So we've got the three different ways to enroll: paper, text, benefit administration system. Is there anything, any other considerations that people need to take into account?
Yeah, absolutely. I think the last thing is communication to employees. And you may have the right administration process, but being able to communicate consistently around open enrollment in several different types of media is really important because people intake information differently. And so we've found that employee engagement and appreciation and benefits is not so much based on the richness of the benefits plan. It's really based on how well employees understand it and appreciate it.
All right, so now we know how open enrollment is working. Now, are all these things applicable throughout the year? Is it too late for people to implement some of the stuff that we're talking about now? Just a couple final thoughts on that.
Yeah, absolutely. It really depends on the size of company that you are. The smaller the company, the later in the year open enrollment tends to be held. Text to enroll is absolutely something that you can implement within 30 days. I would probably hold off on a benefit administration system and jumping forward to that step at this point in the year and maybe starting those conversations early next year. That being said, we're more than happy to help employers be a secondary resource at this point of the year and really just help make open enrollment as efficient and as good of a process as you possibly can.
Well, if nothing else, people can look at what's working for them now and think of ways to improve for next year. Pay attention to what's happening right now and things that you wish would be better, and then you'll get, you know, something to work with there.
Absolutely.
Fantastic. Well, thank you so much for joining me. I really appreciate it. What's the best way for people to contact you?
Email or phone would be great. Otherwise, you can find me at LinkedIn. Once again, my name is Joey Backus with Cottingham and Butler.
Fantastic. Well, thank you for taking the time to help educate people, give them some information. Hopefully, we can do something like this again soon.
Absolutely, Tom. Thanks for having me.
Thanks.